It all comes down to choice. That's the message in a brand new global effort designed to deal with terrorism, reaching out to terrorists before it's too late. Let's go to CNN's Deborah Farrick. She's working the story for us. Deb, what do we know?
Well, Wolf, here's the question. How do you appeal to wannabe jihadis around the world? What is the one thing they all have in common? It's not all that complicated.
For every terror attack, every failed attempt, there's a critical moment. Security experts call it a crossroads for the individual carrying it out.
Truly, terrorism is a choice. Often it's a rational choice, but based on perhaps irrational facts.
That terrorism is a choice may sound obvious, but as this poster shows, it's the first time it's being used as a slogan, uniting countries around the world in a single message. Call it the first global PR campaign targeting potential extremists.
And to engage in that violent extremism is very much a personal choice by the individual. What the poster is trying to reflect is that it is a decision and there are alternatives.
Security experts Mark Fallon and others spent more than a year talking to police around the world, analyzing their counterterrorism strategies.
What works in Singapore is not going to necessarily work in Indonesia or in Great Britain.
Among the findings, some countries like France and the U.S., as seen in the recent Portland plot, treat the threat of radicalization primarily as a crime to be prosecuted. Others, like Singapore, use intelligence to find young men at risk, then stage an intervention relying on family pressure, in some cases even offering a job.
Any successful program is going to be multidimensional, and it's going to involve more than police, it's going to involve more than security, it's got to involve the community, it's got to involve social systems, psychologists, etc.
The findings were recently endorsed by Interpol, the world's largest police organization.
I think it's a brilliant campaign. It shows society that there is more than one way to try to fight terrorism. Military is being used in some parts of the world. Law enforcement is being used around the world. We need to find ways to get these people to be persuaded not to become terrorists.
A global effort to reach disaffected youth, hoping to persuade them to disengage from violence and convince them there are other ways to bring about change.
Now, through Interpol, more than 188 countries were made privy to this particular report. They realized there's no one-size-fits-all approach to fighting terrorism, but by studying what works and building a strategy around a unified message, they hope it will help police agencies tailor efficient strategies to fight terrorism. Wolf.
All right, Deb, thanks very much. Deborah Farrick with that report.